Hello and welcome to Ayurveda with a Mentor. In this video, I will address one very serious question. This is about the safety of Ayurvedic herbs or Ayurvedic medicine. One of the common query of people is, are there steroids in Ayurvedic herbs or Ayurvedic medicine? I look at this query in a very different way. People want to be reassured about the safety of the Ayurvedic treatment or Ayurvedic herbs. Unfortunately, there have been some reports where some Ayurveda practitioners or homeopathic practitioners, they have added steroids, medical drugs in powders or tablets or in liquids. And this is actually a malpractice, an illegal activity. And I want to address this issue in a very sincere and straightforward manner. Before delving deeper into this topic, I would like to clarify one point here. When I use the word steroids, it simply means corticosteroid medical drugs. It doesn't mean some of the phytonutrients that are having steroidal activity. It doesn't mean some of the phytonutrients that are having hormone mimetic activity. These are the topics for some other video, and simply when I use the word steroids, you understand corticosteroid medical drugs. These are generally prescribed by medical experts for specific conditions. They generally evaluate your condition, consider the benefit and risk, and then they prescribe you. These corticosteroids are available in the form of tablets, liquids, ointments and injections. Without going into great detail, it's better to understand the broader perspective under which corticosteroid medical drugs are used. Medical experts use corticosteroids to suppress inflammatory activity. This inflammatory activity is generally present in chronic, progressive and degenerative disorders. It's also present in autoimmune disorders. That's why they prescribe corticosteroids to suppress the inflammation there. And when you are using corticosteroids, it's bound to suppress your immune response or immune system. That's why when you take corticosteroids for a period of few weeks to few months, you are bound to experience some strong side effects. Now, I like to present some of the facts about corticosteroids, medical drugs, and Ayurvedic herbs or Ayurvedic products. The first one is the presence of corticosteroids in any of the Ayurvedic herbal product. It is always an intentional adulteration, and unfortunately this is a malpractice. Next, do Ayurvedic products contain corticosteroids? The answer is no. None of the Ayurvedic products, whether it is based upon Ayurvedic herbs or some of the Ayurvedic minerals or a combination of Ayurvedic herbs or minerals, it can never have corticosteroids as an ingredient. Next, are steroids mixed in Ayurvedic products? Yes, if corticosteroid medical drugs are ever mixed or found in Ayurvedic products, it is always an illegal activity. Whether this is done by a practitioner of Ayurvedic system or homeopathy, it is always an illegal activity. Unfortunately, if it is done by a manufacturer, then it is also an illegal and punishable activity. I like to broaden this hot topic. The question is, can any of the medical drug be ever present in Ayurvedic herbs or Ayurvedic medicine? The answer is no. When I am saying medical drugs, it means any of the painkiller, any of the antibiotics, any of the corticosteroids, or simply any other medical drug. It can never be combined along with Ayurvedic herbs in Ayurvedic products. One of the questions is, when mixing corticosteroids in Ayurvedic herbs or Ayurvedic products is a malpractice and an illegal activity, then why are some people doing it? The simple answer is, corticosteroids are very strong anti-inflammatory agents. So when they are given, they rapidly subside the symptoms of inflammation and they are providing rapid symptomatic relief. This is one of the reasons behind this malpractice and illegal activity. Now, I give you some practical tips that will help you from being deceived or cheated. The first one, when you are getting Ayurvedic treatment, always get it from qualified Ayurveda doctor. When I am saying qualified Ayurveda doctor, I simply mean graduate or postgraduate Ayurveda professionals. These are board certified professionals and you can rely upon them. They undergo same amount of Ayurvedic studies as their medical counterparts. So when you go to Ayurveda doctors, they are very knowledgeable in medical subjects like anatomy, physiology, pathology, diagnostics, line of medical treatment. So they will be able to divide your Ayurvedic treatment. They will be able to follow a line of Ayurvedic treatment that is more suitable for you. Second, can you be 100% assured when you go to Ayurveda doctors? Actually, professionals differ. I cannot guarantee you, but there is always a very high probability when you are going to a qualified person that he will cater to your needs and he will not be just cheating his own profession. The next very important consideration is to have the prescription for what you are taking. It appears to be very simple, but when you take the prescription of your Ayurvedic herbs or Ayurvedic medicine, you will know what you are taking, what have been given to you. There will be some proof that you have taken medicines from a practitioner. So this will be very practical for you if you get a prescription either on paper or in digital format. This practical tip is very, very important. It will drastically reduce your chances from being deceived or cheated. Never accept any loose form of herbs, powders, tablets, capsules, or any other form of Ayurvedic medicine. Always go for proper and intact packaging, even if you have to pay more for it. So always go for proper and intact packaging. When I'm saying proper packaging, it should have the name of the product, all the ingredients and date of manufacturing, best before date, manufacturing company details, and you should be able to contact the manufacturer. These details should be present. When you look at any of the like products that are manufactured by holistic herbalists, you get the complete details on its packaging and you get the complete details on our website. Another practical advice to save yourself further is to get the proper bill or invoice. When you have the appropriate bill or invoice or receipt of the products, you can always trace to the source. You have always a proof with yourself, so this will be very handy for you. I have an observance here. Most of the persons who are falling prey to such type of malpractices, they are going to the quacks, unqualified persons. And another observance that they are going after very inexpensive or cheap Ayurvedic herbs. Definitely, if you want to have entire treatment for a month that is costing only few hundred rupees, it is not possible. But when you are getting quality Ayurvedic products, these are very, very much affordable and you can get them slightly higher cost, but you should appreciate the quality and you should differentiate the quality of the products. Another important suggestion for you. You should be well aware of the side effects of corticosteroids in short term, mid term, and long term. So, whether you are taking corticosteroids as prescribed by medical expert or as mixed or adulterated by some Ayurvedic or homeopathic practitioner, you will be getting some of the side effects in your body and you will have a personal perspective, personal experience of these, and it will work as a guide for you and you can confront, you can ask your practitioner that I am having these type of side effects. Are there some steroids? Is there some possibility of it? I have seen that many times when people approach Ayurvedic practitioner for treatment of chronic disorders, they are having fairly advanced conditions. Sometimes it happens that their conditions are not responding to medical drugs, and at that point of time, they want to start with Ayurvedic treatment. So when somebody wants to start Ayurvedic treatment for chronic disorders, for autoimmune disorders, I always say that essence, the virtue for them. And I give a time frame of 1 month to have initial good relief. They will be able to know that they are moving on the right track with Ayurvedic treatment. They are having some good relief with Ayurvedic treatment within one period of time. But in very advanced conditions, when people are already taking corticosteroids or immunosuppressant drugs, I give a time frame of 2 to 3 months to have initial good relief. This is a must. So again, when you want to have Ayurvedic treatment for chronic disorders, for autoimmune disorders or other complicated conditions, you should have patience. Patience is a virtue here. Some people might feel offended when I have given them the time frame of 1 month, 2 months or 3 months. But actually you want to understand, you should understand the process of healing and cure in Ayurveda. I have a very detailed video where I explain it as 6-step ladder of Ayurvedic healing and cure, and you will be able to understand when you are moving from complicated stage toward healing and cure, or when your condition is being aggravated and you are moving toward complicated or advanced stage. Some person asked me, when they are suspecting that they are receiving some sort of corticosteroids mixed with Ayurvedic herbs, can they test it? Yes, it is possible through drug testing laboratories that are available in major cities. It is an expensive process, but you should be well aware of the side effects of corticosteroids, and in that way you will be able to avoid them. You will not be able to continue these for a long period of time. There are some common questions associated with this topic. The first one is, can Ayurvedic doctors prescribe steroids or other medical drugs? Yes, it is possible. It depends upon the laws of different states within India. But my advice to you, when you are approaching Ayurvedic doctor, you have to rely upon your expertise for Ayurvedic treatment, and you always have medical experts to take care of the medical treatment. Many people, they consider it as a fight between Ayurveda and medical doctors. It is not a fight between Ayurvedic system or medical system, or Ayurveda doctors and medical doctors. Actually, I consider that the healthcare system, it should be centered upon the person, or we should always have a person-centric approach, taking care of their body, mind and consciousness in a very wholesome and integrated manner. Thanks for taking the time to watch this video. If you have some questions about this topic, do write in the comment. I will reply them personally. Finally, adopt Ayurveda and yoga in your life. Have better health and greater happiness now and always. Thank you. Namaste.